On my left, you see the login for Sage Construction Management in a web browser. On the right, you see what the mobile app experience looks like. We'll come back to the mobile app in a little while, so let's go ahead and sign into Sage Construction Management. So once we're signed in, the first thing that we're going to see are any alerts that need our attention. And you can see that I have a couple insurance expirations for a couple different projects of mine, as well as an RFI I haven't had returned to me yet. Let's go ahead and take a look at this RFI. But before I do that, real briefly, you can see an e-sign tab. This is going to show me any documents that are in process to be e-signed. Routing and approval through DocuSign can be set up and monitored here. Let's go back to alerts. Let's bring up that RFI from Dempster & Associates, or to Dempster & Associates. And let's take a quick look at that. So all the screens in Sage Construction Management are very clean, very easy to read. So this is RFI number 8. Please provide an update. If I scroll down here, it's to Larry Dempster. He's supposed to respond by the 27th. He hasn't yet. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and send him a nudge. So I'm going to go ahead and send it again. You can have different formats and templates to the RFIs. And I'm going to put down right here, please answer this now, ASAP. And I'm going to go ahead and hit send. So the system has just sent Larry an email. So it was sent. So let's go ahead and switch hats, and I'm going to pretend that I am Larry Dempster. Larry has received this RFI from Brett, and he's going to click this link in the email to go ahead and open up his portal into Sage Construction Management on this project. So Larry can see information, conflict, place for him to write his response. And he wants to take a look at this photo that Brett had forwarded. So Larry can see that there was a photo of a coffee mug. Okay. So Larry's going to respond. Looks good to me. Should we proceed? So go ahead and save it. And now that's going to go ahead and go back into the system as a response. So if we go back and let's pull up the home screen and go to projects, this is an exception little scorecard here to see what's missing on my projects. I can see I have a project in there without an estimate and so forth. I'm going to go ahead and pull up the Best Buy project. And what I want to do here is show you all the different things that Sage Construction Management can help you with on a project-by-project basis. As I scroll down, you can see a list of favorites. This is a shortcut for me to quickly get to various aspects of the system. We scroll down a little farther, and you can see this full menu showing all the different functionality that's available to a user, ranging from pre-construction, invitation to bid, putting estimates together. Also, estimates can be imported from Sage Estimating or Excel, to contract administration on the client side, so schedule values, change orders to prime contract, so on, procurement, subcontracts, purchase orders, change management, time and expense entry, and of course, field type items such as RFIs, the daily field reports, quality and safety, and even scheduling. If I go ahead and just come back up here to the favorites, let's just do that. Let's just look at schedule. So you can pull up and see that we have an original schedule here. And the scheduling tool in here is very much like Microsoft Project. So here are the list of activities with their duration, and they can be, of course, scheduled start to finish, and so on. Let's go ahead and go back to the project. And what I'd like to do is go ahead and bring up an estimate and show a few details. So again, keep in mind, this estimate could be imported from Excel, it could be built natively in Sage Construction Management, or you could pull it in from Sage Estimating. I'm going to click on the summary. One of the really nice tools that's in the estimating product is the ability to print proposals. So I'm going to go ahead and do just that. You can have different Word templates formatted in different ways. I'm going to group it by division and cost code. And you can see here, obviously, we have a nice formatted proposal form that lists scope information, and then some summary level cost estimate proposal type information here. This can be sent out through the system and e-signed if you choose to. Let's go back to the project again. And again, prime contracts can also be managed here. They can be built from the estimate, or they can be easily imported from a spreadsheet. This gives you an idea of what those look like here. Let's go back to the project home again. And what I want to do real quickly here is show you how you can use the mobile app to create an RFI. Say you're out in the field, you find something, and then you want to finish it up here. So I'm going to go ahead and minimize my screen, and I'm going to call up the mobile app. And what you see here is we're on that Best Buy job. I have my favorites here. Your favorites could certainly be different. And you can access a subset of these. So let's say that I'm out on the job site and I see something that doesn't look quite right on some hardware. Specifically, I see some door hardware for hanging, I guess it's for hanging a curtain. I'm going to take a picture of it here. And I'm going to go ahead and save that. I took a couple, so I'm only going to use one of them. And let's go ahead and add a few additional details. Does the satin finish meet? Oh, misspelled finish. Meet customer spec. And I want to send that to my interior contractor at Beaverton Painting as Paul the Painter. I need an answer by, I'll give him till Friday. Paul. I think chrome would look much better than satin. So I'm just doing this real quick while I'm out on job site. I'm going to finish it back up when I get back to the office. Okay. So we've went ahead and put that in the system. So let's go ahead and go back to the office. I'm going to go ahead and bring my browser up again. And right there was RFI number 2 that we just put in. Let's go ahead and pull it up. And you can see the details that I put in there. So I kind of coding this on my phone. So I want to clean that up a little bit. Spec. And now I could finish out whatever other details I want and go ahead and send it out to the subcontractor. So this is a real quick overview of Sage Construction Management. We're really excited about having this to offer to our customers and to our prospective customers. Thank you.